Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at smart quotes. So here I am in TextEdit, and watch what happens when I type something that has quotes around it. Notice how the straight quotes became curly quotes. All I did was type the quote symbol on my keyboard, shift and apostrophe. Apostrophe is right next to the return key. And I got straight up and down quotes as the keyboard shows, but they changed instantly to curly quotes. Not only that, but they're smart curly quotes because they are facing inside on this one and inside on this one as well. And you can see this has happened simply because of the position of a character near the quote. So for instance, if I typed something like this and I put a quote right before the I, you can see it does the quote that way. If I put it after a letter with a space on the other side, it does it this way. So that's all it does to figure out which way to curl the quotes. Now, almost every app that uses this has this as a preference somewhere. If we go into TextEdit, we look under Preferences, we can see under New Document Preferences we can select whether or not to use smart quotes. I can turn that off. Now that's not going to affect this document, but if I were to create a new document and then type something, let me get the font larger, you can see I get straight up and down quotes now in this document in TextEdit. Now to change this preference in an existing document, all you need to do is go to Edit Substitutions. You can see Smart Quotes is turned off for this one. If I switch to this one here, Substitutions, Smart Quotes is turned on. So I can turn it on and off after I'm already using a document. Of course, in addition to the regular quotes, you have the single quote, which it uses an apostrophe like that. And with it turned off, I get it straight up and down like that. One of the reasons you may have it turned off so they're straight quotes is if you're a coder like me and you're always writing examples of code, say in articles and books that you write. And you don't want to use curly quotes because that's not actually what's used in code. It'll generate errors. So you want to use straight up and down quotes even when you're just writing about it, so there's no confusion for the reader. Another reason you may want to use straight up and down quotes is simply that you like them better. So on Pages you also have the same thing, but the preference appears in a different place. Go to Pages, Preferences, under Auto Correction, it will appear here, Use Smart Quotes. So if I turn that off here right in the middle of a document, now if I have it turned on, I can easily have a straight quote on a case-by-case basis like this. And say I want this to be a straight quote for some reason. It'll turn it into a curly quote, but if I hit Command Z right away, it will undo the last action, which was to automatically change it to substitute a curly quote. So I can get away with that single time that I have the straight quote. Now you can also go the other way. If I have smart quotes turned off, I can get a curly quote by typing it manually. And this is what people had to do before there were smart quotes, especially if you're in publishing. Use the Option key and the left square bracket on keyboard. It's just to the right of the P key. And you can get a curly quote. Do Shift Option and you get it going the other direction. And by the way, the right bracket is Option and the right bracket is a single quote in that direction, and then Shift Option gives you the other one. So you can manually insert these and use the quotes as you want. Now another place you may want to use smart quotes is in mail when composing a message. But you can see I don't have it. It's just a regular straight quote there. Unless you go down into Edit Substitutions and turn on Smart Quotes there. So it's not in the Mail Preferences in this case, but under the Edit menu. And you also have some more control over Smart Quotes by going to System Preferences. Now this only affects certain applications, but if you go to Language and Text and then you go to Text here, you can see there's a setting for Smart Quotes for both the single and double there. And you can not only set it up to do the regular Smart Quotes, which is the top one, but you can set it up for some various other types of quotations. So let's set it here. And now if I switch over to Mail and I type the quote, you can see I get those instead. You can also go down to the last type of smart quote, which is to not use smart quotes. So I can kind of turn it off not quite system-wide because other applications have their own setting, but at least in some applications like Mail and TextEdit, it will obey the system preference for smart quotes. So where you find the settings for smart quotes depends upon the app. Sometimes you find them in the preferences for the app, but the area in the preferences can differ from app to app. So you have to look around. And other times it's just simply under the Edit menu under Substitutions. And then there might be some apps that don't even have any settings at all and simply use the system-wide settings. So here's a look at using or not using smart quotes. Even if it's not something you care that much about, it's useful just to know a little bit more about how your Mac works. Until next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. And go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.